On the Medical Watch tonight, redefining obesity.
Medical reporter Dina Baer has more on a medical first, a new framework for a growing global problem.
It's estimated more than 1 billion people in the world are living with obesity, as defined by the current definition that relies solely on body mass index, or BMI. Now healthcare experts say one size does not fit all.
It's been used for more than 100 years.
It does not measure one's health, does not measure body fat, and it does not measure the composition of the body or where the fat is located.
Dr. Robert Kushner says it's time to move the field forward when it comes to body mass index.
So one can have an elevated BMI and yet be very muscular like a football player, or someone cannot have a high BMI but have extra body fat because their muscle mass is so low.
The Northwestern medicine physician helped craft the new definition of obesity as part of the Lancet Diabetes and Endocrinology Special Commission. Instead of relying on a single number, BMI, doctors are calling for a more nuanced approach to classifying the condition.
Are you someone who is gaining extra body weight but is healthy and you can go on living your life with maybe attention, eating healthy and being more physically active? Or is your weight starting to impair your health and you should then take better care and seek medical advice?
The new recommendations, backed by 75 medical organizations around the world, call for healthcare providers and patients to consider multiple key factors when it comes to determining health risk, including waist circumference and fat distribution around the body, in addition to BMI.
I think the commission's report is monumental in the sense that it's the first take from getting away at just BMI and looking more specifically at the individual.
The new definition consists of two categories, preclinical obesity and clinical obesity. Patients with preclinical obesity may have a higher BMI and some extra body fat while maintaining normal organ function. They may also have an increased risk for diseases like type 2 diabetes, heart problems, and certain cancers.
They just may need some counseling on how to live a healthy life, don't gain any more body weight, eat healthy, become physically active, and be monitored.
Patients with clinical obesity may exhibit shortness of breath, aching knees and hips, swelling in the legs, urinary incontinence, headaches, and obesity-induced heart failure.
So we're trying to differentiate, let's say, a condition which is not impairing your health versus one that is impairing your health, and that has never been done before.
The commission hopes more healthcare providers will adopt the new definition to help identify patients who need special intervention, as well as those who do not. Back to you.